it's on me. I bought breeze for the hotel. And now we outside. And I will never.
Earning a collegiate athletic scholarship is never easy. Whether you play baseball, basketball, football, and you're trying to get a D1 scholarship, or even play at the JUCO level, it's never easy. In this video, I'm going to share the tips and tricks and the do's and don'ts so you can earn your college athletic scholarship no matter what sport you play. Before I show you the do's, one of the most important things is to make sure becoming a college athlete is what you want to do. You're spending almost half of your day, every day, working out, studying film, being in meetings, being in practice. You still have to go to class. Make sure it's something you can manage and make sure it's something that you really, really want to do. It is extremely time-consuming and it's very difficult. So before you even follow any of these steps to gain an athletic scholarship, really think deep and down if it's something that you want to commit to. If you in, let's get to the video. Step one is you have to assess yourself. Currently in high school athletics, there are over 8 million different athletes and only 480,000 take that next step to becoming a college athlete. So you have to be honest and assess yourself and find out what level you think you can play at. If you're 5'5" and you want to play quarterback, you know, unless you are like Peyton Manning, odds are Division I, you know, is not for you. You have to have the right measurables, the right quickness. Are you explosive? Can you run, et cetera, et cetera? Are you tall? Are you short? You have to know all of these things and assess yourself, or else you're going to waste your time and waste a college coach's time, which no one ever wants to do. So step one is give yourself an honest assessment. Can I be a D1 basketball player? I'm 5'6", 130. Can I play point guard at Duke? Probably not. You have to know yourself. Don't have too much pride. Be honest with yourself and assess what level you can play at. That step alone can separate you from thousands of other athletes, because many athletes don't know where they should be at, and they go out and they send their film to Alabama, to Florida State, to Duke, North Carolina, LSU, when really they can only be playing at some Division III schools at best, and they're just wasting their time. So step one might be the most important step. Is to make sure your academics are on point, have great grades. Honestly, on average, you will want to have at least a 2.5 GPA. Make sure your grades are intact, and make sure you're at school. If a college coach comes to visit you and you're not there, it's not like he's just going to wait around for you day after day after day. Make sure you're in school. Make sure you're doing the right things. Don't be a class clown. Don't skip class, because that stuff comes back to you. Make sure you're in school and your grades are on point. Perfecting your craft. No college coach is going to recruit an athlete who's one-dimensional, no Division I college coach is going to recruit an athlete who's one-dimensional, can only do one thing, can't do this. Make sure you perfect your craft. If you play basketball, make sure you can shoot, make sure you can dribble, make sure you can defend. If you play, you know, quarterback, make sure you can run, make sure you can throw, make sure you're smart. Make sure you perfect your craft. Be able to do everything so a college coach can have more use for you, which will give them a better chance of giving you that scholarship if you can do a little bit of everything instead of a lot of only one thing. Make a name for yourself. Get your name out there. Put together a good highlight tape with some of your best plays. Not too long, not too short. Also with some clips showing what you can do, showing you can do everything. Stay in constant contact with coaches that are around the level that you believe you can play at. As you can see right here, I was emailing coaches almost daily my film. You have to be active. You have to be proactive in getting your name out there. You know, you can't just wait for them to come to you unless you're like a godly athlete. You know, unless you're like a LeBron James, you have to go to them. You have to go get them. You have to show them that you want to be there. And if you're good enough, they'll return the favor back to you. If it's in your budget, if you have the chance, go to different schools, camps, showcases, perform in front of a whole bunch of coaches to continue getting your name out there. Now, if you can't afford that, because most camps do cost a lot, don't sweat it, it's not something crucial. But if you can go to camps and get your name out there, it helps quite a bit. Hopefully people are watching this as freshmen, but if you're like a senior, junior, it may not really apply to you, but start as early as possible. The faster you start, the more you're on a coach's radar, and they can continue building that relationship with you. So down the line, gaining an athletic scholarship is a piece of cake because they already know you, almost like you're one of their own children. Continue to be proactive. College coaches are extremely busy. You have to constantly keep calling, keep emailing, constantly be proactive. Stay active. Do not send one email or leave one voicemail and think that's enough. If you think you're good enough to play somewhere and you need them to see your film, keep sending it. Keep calling. 9 times out of 10, they don't even see it. So stay as proactive as you possibly can. Another tip is to make sure you know how to properly speak to people. If a college coach comes to visit you and, you know, you have bad posture, you know, you're nervous, stuff of that nature, you're going to build a bad relationship with them off the jump, and it could possibly result in him not recruiting you. So make sure you know how to properly speak to people, have good posture, use good vocab, proper grammar, stuff like that, because it goes a long way with coaches. The next step would be, during the off season, continue working and playing as many different leagues and or games as you can. Not only will it get you more exposure, but during this off season, it will keep you in shape, help you keep perfecting your craft and keeping your tools. Because the worst thing you can do is have an opportunity to perform in front of a college coach, and during the off season, you're not working and you lose your skill and you come out rusty, and it costs you big time. So during the off season, continue working, play in different leagues, you know, soccer, basketball, you know, play club, play AAU, volleyball, stuff like that. Keep playing, keep affecting your game. So when it's time to actually show it, you're ready to. The last step is just to continue to work hard and never give up. You know, you can get a scholarship when you're in sixth grade, or you can get a scholarship offer the last week of your senior year. You can even get it when you walk on at a school eventually. You want to do, it's not going to come easy. You're going to have to work hard, stay to it, stay on the path, stay on the course, and eventually you will get that offer that you are looking for. Now, I've shown you the tips and tricks, the positive, you know, the do's, and now I'm going to break down the don'ts, the top things you do not want to do if you want to earn a collegiate athletic scholarship. Number one, do not lie. Countless times, people, you know, they play basketball, they play point guard, they're 5'9", but on their highlight tape, they say they're 6'1". Or they play wide receiver, and they're 5'11", but they say they're 6'3". Do not lie. First of all, a college coach eventually is going to come meet you. And if he comes and meets you, and you say you're 6'3", he's going to see you. That lie is going to catch up. Be as open and honest as you possibly can, because it shows a lot about your character, which college coaches definitely care about. Another big don't is do not act a fool on the internet. As you can see here, there's countless situations where people lose their scholarships just because of what they post on social media. So be careful, because anyone can see it and it never really goes away. Don't post Snapchats if you're out drinking, you know, don't tweet ignorant, irrational things. You have to be extremely careful because you never know who's watching. Another don't is don't harm your body. If you're really serious about being an athlete, you can't drink, you can't smoke, you can't do drugs. You know, there's constant drug tests, everything of that nature. Me personally, I've never done any of those things. I feel like if you are a serious athlete, you should never want to put that stuff in your body. Especially if you're in high school, that's not good for you. So do not drink, do not do drugs. Keep your body as a temple so it can function for you at all times. Another huge don't is do not play the scholarship game. What the scholarship game is, you know, you may get a few scholarships and you let it get to your head. If you get an offer, make sure you look into every school, give every school a chance, and find the right place for you. Because some people, they get a few scholarships and they keep playing games with coaches. They get on the phone with coaches just trying to bring in as many offers as they can so they can brag about it, and eventually signing day comes around and all those offers are pulled, then you have nowhere to go and you have to settle for less. Another don't is don't be unreachable. You have to have some method of contact so a coach can get in contact with you if need be. Make sure you have, you know, if you don't have a cell phone, it's kind of tough, but it's understandable. Make sure you have an email, you know, address if they want to mail you, a number if they want to call you, text you, social media. Make sure you are reachable, because if a coach wants to contact you and they don't have your information, they really just might throw you out the window and you can possibly lose a scholarship. And in my opinion, the biggest don't, which I sort of did, do not wait until it's too late. Do not wait until your senior year to really go out and follow these steps. If you start playing sports in eighth grade, start in eighth grade. If you start as a freshman, start as a freshman. Be proactive in following these steps to ensure that you get that scholarship that you're looking for. Obviously, if you guys don't know by now, I'm a Division I football player, but as I previously said, all these steps are the same. If you want me to drop a video on my Division I story, just comment, let me know, and I can get that video for you.